In news overseas, women in Afghanistan now prohibited from getting university education. The Taliban announced a nationwide ban on Tuesday in the latest move restricting women's rights. The Deputy Special Representative of the United Nations Chief in Afghanistan calls the move deeply concerning. The U.S. also condemning the ban. It warns the Taliban of countermeasures as well as further isolation from the rest of the world.
This unacceptable stance will have significant consequences for the Taliban and will further alienate the Taliban from the international community and deny them the legitimacy they desire.
Despite promising softer rule when they seized power last year, the Taliban have since ratcheted up restrictions on all aspects of women's lives. Universities were already implementing new rules, including gender-segregated classrooms. Most teenage girls across the country have also been banned from secondary school education.
And the Islamist militants freed two Americans in detention in Afghanistan. The U.S. says the move seems to be a goodwill gesture on the part of the Taliban. This as it made clear there was no prison swap, nor was there money that exchanged hands. Washington did not provide any details on the two Americans, but media reports say one of them was a filmmaker who was arrested in August while filming at the site of a U.S. drone attack that killed an al-Qaeda leader. Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing today with our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Good morning, guys. Here are the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community. We begin in Vancouver, British Columbia, where the community has quickly stepped up to help more than 20 Filipino-Canadian families who recently lost their homes in an apartment fire. For her part, School Board Trustee Leilani Tumaning posted an appeal on social media.
Ang puring na support, wala akong masabi. Ang bilis. Kaya kami atang pinakauna dito. Nung 30 ng gabi, nandito na ako. Pero before pa that, may nagpunta na ng lunchtime, nag-deliver ng hot food.
We used to live in that building in 2017, so we really wanted to help the community, and we feel how devastating the situation is, especially during Christmas time.
It breaks our heart, so kaya kami right away na tumawag, nag-message ka agad si Leilani. So right away, we try our best na makatulong kahit maliit na bagay.
A tenant at the apartment said her employer and co-workers have also been very helpful.
They allow us to get some foods in there and clothing as well. And even yung mga co-workers namin, there are times they give us some goods.
Meanwhile, parts of downtown San Francisco were lit up by handmade Philippine Christmas lanterns or paroles from over 20 different contingents in the Bay Area. After a two-year hiatus due to COVID restrictions, the 20th Parole Lantern Festival returned to the Yerba Buena Center for the Arts.
This is the first place where we had the festival in 2003. And so now, many years later, we're coming back. It's really great to just see so much community members in the space.
Inside, attendees were entertained by children singing Christmas carols while enjoying free food. People were also given the opportunity to make their own paroles to take home.
This is the hardest decision I've ever had to make.
And finally, in entertainment news, the new season of Emily in Paris has romantic entanglements aplenty, but it also features a trio of strong young women. Lily Collins returns to her role as the titular Emily, who is trying to find her footing in a new country.
This season, we get to explore the other characters and the other actors' trajectories with Emily, but also without, which was really exciting for me as a viewer and also as a producer in the show. And you get to see Emily more rooted in her new French culture and friends more so than other seasons.
Co-star Camille Rizzat says that just like the fans, the show's cast and crew are also curious and trying to figure out how the season will resolve its storylines. And it gets crazy. Emily in Paris starts its third season on Netflix on December 21st. And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.